Welcome everyone to my talk about developments at NISZ, these tips behind the scenes. So this was originally scheduled by László Németh, who could not make it here, so I must be stepping in. So this talk is mostly about what we do in NISZ on the very low levels. Because last year there was a talk by László about how to build a developer team for in-house competence. And that was a little bit higher level talk. This will show on the very lower level happenings. So this is more about or more for people who are just starting to develop LibreOffice or people who are starting to mentor such people. So for the last year we had about 170 bug fixes. Most of that was done by László Németh, and about 50 was by Balázs Varga in chart area. He talked about that yesterday. And 20 other bug fixes by other members of the team, like myself and the junior developers. Recently, we are 4 members, so not all of those people are still with us. But we have a few newcomers too. Okay, so how do we develop LibreOffice? First of all, this is a huge software project, one of the biggest free software projects. That's nothing new. And so nobody knows the whole software. Any newcomer should just let go that and ever they will be able to understand all of that. So the key for successful development is effective self-study of the problem and the related code base. And our developers don't have a lot of time on their hands to get experience. So our focus is to learn the crucial part of the problems and avoid future pitfalls, which is this talk about. So understanding a problem through an example. Recently we had filed a bug, my team, in RTF documents. Size of spaces is different in Word and Writer. Well, this was a little bit of ambiguous, but understanding a problem through UI testing, I mean testing on the actual software, it revealed that not always is this happening only in space sequences. So misunderstanding a problem or relying entirely on the bug description is a problem that we should try to avoid. We should collect every possible questions about the problem and answer it in LibreOffice and in Microsoft Office. So what is happening in Microsoft Office, what is happening in LibreOffice, that's the key to understand. So, and we think it's much cheaper to double the time on problem analysis in the program interfaces and in the test files than making pointless or inefficient code reading and development. So after understanding the problem here, it was discovered that Word puts a 1/6 EM long extra length to space sequences. And that's not exactly what the original bug report said. So don't trust that. Okay, choosing the right tool for Microsoft Office interoperability problems, the best tool for analyzing is Microsoft Office itself. And analyzing the OXML files generated by Microsoft Office. For example, using only Microsoft Office, you should create an OXML baseline file, then make only a single editing change or difference reproducing the problem in the file, and save it as a second test file. And you should compare that using OpenXML SDK on Windows, which is a Microsoft tool, but it's freely available and very useful for us, or this simple script called ODIFF, which was written by Laszlo. I will show it in a next slide. So to analyze export problems, on the other hand, of LibreOffice, you must check the OXML files exported by LibreOffice. But the first thing to find is the related OXML elements or attributes using Microsoft Office and the XML comparison tool. So it's this little script called ODIFF developed by Laszlo for Linux use case for Linux users. It can show the text-based differences of OXML and ODF documents, and it highlights the change of the docx document.xml file. We added a comment to a paragraph, and the file format stores it, as you can see, as a comment reference element with the ID part of the comment. I will change to Firefox, I hope, and show that. Yes. So this is ODIFF, a simple tool available at numbertext.org/ODIFF. That's Laszlo's personal site. So it's really simple bash script, but it can show you or highlight you the differences between XML files on Linux. Okay, so yeah, for beginner to learn, it's a good way to create our own tools, because it can speed up learning process and development also. And once you have checked the OXML difference between files made by Microsoft Office and files made by Office and LibreOffice, it's also important to check the OXML standard too, and sometimes even ODF standard too. Another thing to do is reading the code actively, which means we should forget OpenGrok and API documentation and start to use Git grep, checking the header files for suspicious member variables and methods, and use Git log to find a place of related code parts. So once we know the XML which we are searching for, Git log can help. And sometimes you can find even previous commits that can be reused for the current problem. And also, it's Git log is very useful for understanding the code itself through its history. And not only for regressions, but generally understanding what's happening. It's also a good idea to use shell debug frequently to check that we are in the right place during code reading and problem solving, and check quickly the code execution. That is shown here, that code part above was extended by a shell debug, and in command line execution of the docx export from ODT resulted in this debug line at the end. So that's how it works. So fixing the bug, if you are lucky, solution for our problem has already been in the Git repository, and mastering Git grep and Git log is one of the fastest way to fix a problem. We have usually multiple ways to fix a bug, and finding the best is sometimes the hardest, and usually we have not got, at least in this team, 3 man months to fix a single bug. So the aim is to find a solution that is good enough. It's also a good idea to ask for help through Gerrit, usually from your mentor and experts of this particular area, to review an initial commit. So they could help finding best solution for the problem. And if you want to get your commit accepted, you should add a working unit test and a compact commit description with a straightforward one-line summary and possibly with the magic word fix. So, unit tests. There are many ways to do unit tests in LibreOffice codebase. Simplest thing to do that is searching through git grep or test file reading, copying and modifying existing unit test, and usually those are under sw/QA and sc/QA. Most frequently used way to for our kinds of interoperability problems is the XPath testing. The biggest problems could be a bad XPath problem here. So to fix a bad pass, you should remove end of the pass to get a working XPath assertion. And then extending it with element by element carefully, choosing the correct bracket selection when the selected level contains more elements. So, speeding up development, it's essential to have a growth mindset, which is a working attitude for the problem solver. Knowing that we can solve the task because we can learn everything about the problem and its unknown solution. With this growth mindset, even the most complex task could be an interesting and entertaining puzzle, but without it, even the simplest one could be a nightmare. Under this link, there is a TED talk about this growth mindset by Carol Dweck. And one of the most important tasks of mentoring is to keep and strengthen the growth mindset of the mentored colleagues. So that's what Laszlo is doing. Examples of some bugs that we have fixed with these methods. These were usually fixed by Laszlo. So, first example is page layout of writer for supporting whole page background color. This was using git grep, git log, and some shell debug macros. Laszlo was able to narrow the problem down, and its solution only to a single file in the code base. Microsoft Office does the same since decades, but only for full pages, so Writer is better now because you can use different background colors, gradients, and tiled bitmaps for pages with different page styles. So on the right, you can see what is happening in 6.3. Solution was this patch, only a few program lines. And of course, this resulted in working PDF export, which is very good for up-to-date digital media creation. Okay, so another example. There was this very much wanted bug fix, even in OpenOffice Bugzilla, to support native copy from calc to writer tables. And in 6.1, or until 6.1, there was an OLE object inserted, but now we can extend writer tables easily with the cell data copied from calc using Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V. And the code base of calc and writer are so different that the originally planned fix by the star division original creator of the code base would have been taken a lot of work and leaving the problem unresolved for very long time. I think I found this bug report in OpenOffice Bugzilla from 2003 or so. So what Laszlo did was to copy all of the table content in 6.2, and in 6.3 it was even further developed so that only the part of the calc table that is filtered gets inserted. So the solution was this little bit of code. So instead of developing a new filter to handle this kind of special data transfer, Laszlo has found a two-step workaround, simplifying the solution. So the fix inserts the clipboard data as a temporary table at the place of the text cursor and copies back its contents as native text table data to the clipboard. Remove the table and insert the native text table data in the native text table of writer. This is the main part of the original fix. There is still a to-do about the visible temporary table, but non-debug builds don't show that problem. Okay, so one more example of our methods. Most complex problem is to add new features of to LibreOffice, which was supporting text move during change tracking. This is something Word does, and it marks it text moving by double green underlines, as you can see in this corner of the picture. So breaking down the problem resulted in the to-do list that we should keep the actual content of the document, because LibreOffice imported the deleted part, which is the first paragraph, as not deleted text. Then use deletion and insertion temporarily to show and handle the text moving. And also it would be nice to have a way to show the text moving on the user interface of LibreOffice, so the double green underline. This left part of the slide shows what we have currently. It's much better than showing the deleted part as undeleted, but no double green underline yet. And fixing this problem was surprisingly simple, like this handling the first two of the previous side, first two problems, fixing the document content which showed up as undeleted and importing text moving as insertion only consisted of these two lines. So basically we handle the move from and move to as insertion and deletion. One more example of what we are doing, only these simple methods, is a change tracking. And our aim with change tracking in docx format is to create a stable tool for the top use case of change tracking, which is editing legal text. That happens quite often in our user base. And the recent improvements of Michael Stahl from SIB opened the way to achieve this. So we started to fix the most serious problems and corner cases of change tracking. And now LibreOffice in master keeps most formatting change data during docx import and export. And it can use these to reject character and paragraph formatting changes, including changes of paragraph styles and numbering. So you can see on the left side that a lot of such formattings were not imported and applied in former versions, but now all of that on the top can be imported correctly, just like Word does. And this is how it looks in the Git history from Laszlo. It was quite a lot of work this year, but it is doable even with simple methods. And this is how it looks in the Git history of Balázs. And we fixed a lot of chart interoperability issues. And we are on the right track with help from all of the developer community to fix more complex problems too. So that's basically how the methods that I just explained can work in practice. So that was it. Thank you for the attention. And if there are any questions, please. Okay, so thank you.